You may not know that we are in the final days of the giant silk moth season. Perhaps you've seen one of these large bugs. The other day, News Channel 5 anchor George Mallet snapped this picture of a huge Luna moth right on his front porch. Tonight, as our conservation correspondent Bridget Butler reports, these amazing insects are the focus of a project at Paul Smith College.
A little bit delicate. Dr. Janet Mihuc says there's only a few weeks left of a special season here in the North Country.
I'll let go and we'll see if it'll just sit.
Giant silk moth season.
These individuals typically in our area are out between the last week of May and the middle of July. We have probably only about 8 species that you could really count on potentially seeing in all of northern New York.
The Luna moth, the huge Cecropia moth, and the dainty rosy maple moth are just a few of the species that might be found under outdoor lights this summer.
So this one is called a Promethea. They have a really interesting life history and life cycle because they're only out as adults for a very short time, and as adults they don't feed. They're basically, when they are in their adult form, they're seeking a mate, and that's their sole purpose.
Mihuc says silk moths are in decline due to habitat destruction, light pollution, and a parasitic fly that was imported to control gypsy moths.
These insects have a role to play just in the ecosystem as potential food, but at the same time, there's things that we have done that has affected their populations.
So now she's asking the public to help document where they're spotted in northern New York.
Project Silk Moth relies on people's natural curiosity to snap a picture and share it. Sightings can be submitted online or by smartphone.
We now have the technology that we didn't used to have before, where you can get much more data from citizen scientists than would have been possible before the internet.
And those sightings will provide records that will allow biologists like Mihuc to track changes in the future.
There's been many species of both insects and other animals that where their geographic ranges have shrunk when we didn't really even notice it. So having this kind of information can help.
For Echo and News Channel 5, I'm conservation correspondent Bridget Butler.